There's a school teacher who gets choked, grabbed, and basically drugged down a hallway in a school because, according to her, the cop thought she was a student, not a teacher. But why would you treat a student that way is her question. Let's put up her picture for a mask as well as the choking. You see that? Okay. Let's keep it up. A school resource officer, a cop, is under investigation after being accused of dragging a substitute teacher down the hallway by her throat at Eagles Landing High School in Henry County. This is in the state of Georgia. Nia King is 22 years of age, says two students were getting ready to fight. She tried to intervene to prevent it from escalating, according to WSB Channel 2. King says she backed away when the two students started actually fighting. She was never involved in any physical contact. And that was when the resource officer grabbed her by the neck. Now, I did some additional investigating into this story. I'm going to give you my conclusion as to why the cop grabbed her. But there's more to the incident. The officer reportedly reportedly proceeded to drag her down the hallway into the office. Okay? The incident was caught on camera by students recording the fight. Once we pushed down the hall, I got trampled from the left to the right of the hall, and now I'm back into the middle of the fight. As I was back in the middle of the fight, the SRO just grabs me by the neck, and the fight is still continuing to go on. And she dragged me all the way from the middle of the hall towards her office, King told WSB-TV. Ms. King continued by saying the officer did offer her aid when they reached the office, but no initial explanation as to why she was dragged down the hall by her throat. She asked me, do I need EMS? Do I need the nurse? Do I need some water? I just told her, I need you to leave because you just drug me from that point to this point and I couldn't breathe, but you wouldn't talk, said King. She stepped out and then she came back in and told me, oh, I was trying to save you. I was trying to save you because they said you got hit. Now, let me say this. So understand the scene so far. Cop comes in, misreads the situation, grabs a school teacher thinking it's a student, chokes the student against policy, protocol, and training, grabs the student, drags them down the hallway, proceeds to realize, well, damn, this is a school teacher. Offers aid. School teacher says, I don't want your damn aid. I want you to leave because of what you just did. Cop leaves. Cop comes back with a story. Oh, that? I was trying to save you. You see, they told me you got hit. That's what it was. There's more. The officer's hand was around her neck. And this is what was in the footage that we saw. Is that a position of somebody being saved? Asked King's father while demonstrating a chokehold. King added that she has been a substitute teacher at the school for nearly every day since September, meaning people know her, all right? She also said that she has been mistaken for a student before, but had met the officer involved several times. We are still in the process right now of obtaining, gathering information, and reviewing to make sure the investigation is done. We are working in conjunction with the school. Said the Henry County Police Captain, Randy Lee, all right? Lee also said, I mean, it was transparent. He said that their training does not teach chokeholds or neck restraints, but they do apply those tactics if deadly force is justified or warranted. No student, teacher, or anybody should be treated like that, said King. There is a pending investigation into this matter. No further information is available at this time, said the Henry County School System. They emailed that to WSB-TV. Good reporting by Channel 2. Okay, so let's be very clear. The officer likely believed this was a student, possibly even a student who was a catalyst to the fight. Now, in additional conversations that I've had with individuals who are involved, the description of one of the individuals in the fight, the clothing description, kind of matched the clothing of the school teacher. And they believe this officer assumed that clothing and that person were the same. Came in, violated policy and protocol, thinking it was a student, and it was actually a teacher. So the question is, well, why would you even treat a student that way, right? Okay, there it is. AB, thoughts here.
The question is, why would you treat any human being that way that you are saying that you were trying to save, right? You thought you were going to get away with treating a student like that because you assumed that a student wouldn't report it for whatever reason, because you would use your authority to prevent them from doing that. And now you're caught. And this can't be the first time that you've used this type of tactic, right, in a situation, because you felt comfortable enough to do it in front of a crowd of people who were recording an altercation. Right. So this is why we're doing further investigations. Lawsuits are coming. Right. Mm-hmm. Because y'all did not protect not only this teacher. It sounds like the students involved in this situation were not protected because right. there is still a fight occurring while you are dragging another human being by their neck and they can't breathe. But we've seen this before. So here we go.
Yeah, here we go. Definitely more developments will come. We will give you those updates as it happens.